there's a lot of people that live with rejection. Rejection by a family, society, a relative, the work environment. But rejection can be used in two different ways. Rejection can either bring a person down where the self-esteem is so low that they gain weight, lose weight, they even consider to commit suicide, because rejection is a weapon that can kill somebody. Other people take rejection as a boost or fuel to get better at something. When in reality, if you look at it from a spiritual perspective, rejection, every time you reject it, is because you're getting close to your destiny. Society will reject because you're good. Every time somebody is good at something, especially if the enemy knows that, you will be rejected. An example we have, Jesus. Jesus was rejected by the Jews. He had to turn to the Gentiles. Joseph was rejected by his brothers. Because why? Because he had dreams. See, every time you're good at something, and dreaming could be something that it doesn't necessarily, you need money to dream, or you need a good house or a good name. Everybody can dream, but every time you dream big, you will be rejected, because dreams will only bring you closer to your destiny. The only catch about rejection is that you don't have to get stuck in one area in one season. Rejection has to be used nowadays as a fuel, because you're getting close to your destiny. Right now, rejection has to be embraced to a way saying, you know what, I'm changing my life, I'm getting close to something, and move forward. Rejection will bring to your divine appointment, to your divine contact. Many people who are rejected wander around. They just start walking for no reason. They just start doing things for no reason. When in reality, the good rejection will align you with your path for success. That's enough for today.